Hi folks, it's Lou. Nathan unfortunately couldn't be with us today. I've got a new guest host, my lovely wife Janet, and this is
Church Chatter. We decided to take some cliches heard on a daily basis and research the validity of them. Are they fact? Are they fiction?
Renowned botanist Dr. Vering Lederhosen, researching the question, is the grass really greener on the other side of the fence?
To me, it looks like the grass is greener on your side.
I think it's greener over there.
On the other side.
I must say, look, guys, just looking at these samples right now, I would have to say, this is very brown. This one is very green. It's brown.
Here we are in an ordinary living room to answer the question, is it as easy as taking candy from a baby? Renowned child psychologist Dr. Sven Little is researching the question.
Well, you can see here we have our first specimen, Sarah Determan, and we'll present the object, the candy, to the baby.
Here you go.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Take the candy.
Just here. Yes, there we go. All right, and we will begin the experiment. Watch the baby. Yes.
Go!
Dr. Little.
As you can see, it was very, very easy to actually steal the candy from the baby. In fact, the baby dropped the candy. I would say it is very, in fact, easy to steal candy from a baby.
As you can see, there was one that's bigger and one that's smaller. Let's go.
Hey, guys.
Hey! Hey, Melissa.
Hey! Whoa!
So I think we can clearly conclude that the bigger you are, the harder that you fall.
We now take you to the offices of renowned pigmentologist, Dr. Peter Gorbachev, who is researching the question, is that really as exciting as watching paint dry?
And we're going to wire him up with our excitometer here. Basically, there's no reading on the excitometer. I would also like to point out that our subject has fallen asleep.
Perhaps we need a wider sampling.
Yes, I think that's a good idea. Oh, wow, yeah. It's almost off the chart here. Clear visual signs of excitement here with this larger board. I think the evidence is conclusive here that it's the larger it is, the more exciting it is.
Well, I don't know about you, Luke, but I think that last segment left some questions unanswered.
There seems to be a clear correlation with the size of the painting and the excitement of the subjects. It's a little hard to draw firm conclusions from that. If we had a larger object, perhaps we could generate more excitement out of the subject.
So how large are you talking about here?
The size of a house or billboard, I think. Clearly,
or building, perhaps?
A building, yeah, I think we can clearly generate excitement on the order of probably giggles, frankly.
Well, I happen to have a building in mind. That might generate a lot of excitement if we painted that.
I fully endorse this project. I'm very excited about the prospects of this future research.
It's for science.